about Staten Island and a shared environment that we experience. A friend of mine had pointed out that my work, my entire body of work as he knew it, reminded him of a folk from William Faulkner about Faulkner's desire to talk about home. As my little stamp of native soil would always provide me with enough to talk about and to report in on for a lifetime, and I would never ever tire of doing so. 10 years ago, for the Staten Island Museum for the 125th anniversary, I was asked to do this by Elizabeth Egbert, the late Elizabeth Egbert, who was their director at the time, and she knew that I did a lot of paintings having to do with science and biology and conservation, and also portraiture. So she asked me if I would come up with something that would bring together art and science. These three women whose painting are workers at the Native Plant Center, and they are experts at being able to identify and nurture native seed. And they're in demand around the city. They're working in the greenhouse out there, but they're really wonderful women who they have a special talent. And so that's one way that people can buy bottles and help the environment. External Forces is a series I did a couple of years ago based on the idea that artists need, or many artists need, an environment, a natural environment for inspiration and also for honing their craft, for practicing, for rehearsal. And sometimes their work is about this outdoor natural environment. So I had this idea to do a series of paintings of artists who were practicing and working outdoors. And this particular piece was done from a dance in the forest, something that was choreographed and conceived of by Melissa West, these were her musicians, and they had done a dance through the High Rock Park. So the dancers haven't shown up yet. The piece on to my left is Melissa West and Laura Neese, another Staten Island dancer, and they were doing a sort of impromptu kind of dance through an environment, through an area where Hurricane Sandy destroyed home once stood. And it's sort of, I guess it was like an elegy to what was lost during Hurricane Sandy. At the same time, it's also just an awareness of what needs to be done to preserve the Blue Belts.